In this video, we'll uncover the symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency. Hi, I'm Dr. Zarowski from newvisionexcel.com. If you're new to the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that little bell notification, and I'm gonna help you excel your health. In this video, we're talking about the symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency. You hear a lot of people talk about B12 because it's a very important vitamin for the body. It's very important for the red blood cells. It's very important for proper functioning DNA and also a proper functioning nervous system. Now, there's a couple ways that we can get B12 in the body. We can get it from animal products, eating animal products. We can get it through supplementation, and we can also get it through the intestinal flora. It's actually able to create B12. Now, there's many reasons that people have vitamin B12 deficiency. First of all, the elderly are more prone to B12 deficiency, those who are following a very poor quality diet, those who are following a vegan diet, those who have stomach acid imbalances, those who are taking antacids, and also those people who are taking some sort of prescription drug. Many prescription drugs can actually deplete you of vitamin B12. So let's go ahead and talk about this vitamin B12 deficiency, some of the symptoms you'll get from it, and then at the end of the video, I'll talk about how you need to actually get more of it in your body and the proper way to supplement with it. So the first symptom on our list here is going to be fatigue, also associated with muscle weakness. Now, when you take fatigue, muscle weakness, and combine it with chronic pain, and we're talking about chronic musculoskeletal pain, then essentially this sounds a lot like the diagnosis of fibromyalgia. Now, clinically, we see fibromyalgia all the time. And one of the things that kind of irritates me about that whole thing is that many people are told they have fibromyalgia and they just live with it the rest of their life. But yet there's some natural things that you can do. And many people who have fibromyalgia start supplementing with B12 and they find that the symptoms start to diminish quite a bit. So if you're someone who has fibromyalgia, someone who has chronic pain, someone who has fatigue and weakness, then definitely look to B12 here. The next here is swollen tongue. That's known as glossitis. Next on our list is hearing and vision problems. So people who have tinnitus, for instance, B12 can be a factor in that, and many people report they are getting a relief and the tinnitus is starting to go away once they have sufficient levels of B12. And then vision problems, because chronic B12 deficiencies can affect the optic nerve, so it can affect your vision. So once again, if we want to have good hearing, good vision, that we want to have sufficient B12 levels. Neuropathy associated with paresthesia. So this is basically, you know, shooting pains, this is numbness, this is tingling, pins and needles, that sort of thing. Now, one of the things about chronic B12 deficiency is that it is going to affect the spinal cord, it's going to affect the nervous system, it's going to affect the peripheral nerves, and it's even going to affect the brain. And so if we want to have, you know, a well-functioning nervous system that does not have symptoms of neuropathy and paresthesia, then we got to have sufficient B12 levels. Next here is mood changes. So we just said how it actually affects the brain. So this chronic deficiency can affect the brain in many ways, one in which is a imbalance in neurotransmitter levels. So people who have B12 deficiencies report paranoia, depression, anxiety, and many other mood changes. And so if we want to have, you know, good healthy mood, good functioning brain, normalized neurotransmitter levels, we need sufficient B12. Immune health. So someone who's getting sick a lot, there's a good chance that B12 can be a factor, as it plays a huge role in cellular immunity, and that's what the research shows us. And then last big symptom here is poor sleep. Okay, so once again, the research shows us that B12 plays a huge role in melatonin production and release. It plays a role in your normal sleep and wake cycles, and it also plays a role in your overall circadian rhythm. So if you want to have good, high quality sleep, then B12 may be a factor that you need to think about. So the next question that you might have here, well, if I have a B12 deficiency, how do I increase B12 in the body? Well, the first way you could do it is through consuming B12 rich foods. B12 rich foods include beef liver, sardines, Atlantic mackerel, lamb, wild-caught salmon, nutritional yeast, grass-fed beef, cottage cheese, feta cheese, and then also eggs. Now, if you're someone who has a B12 deficiency and you want to increase your B12 levels very fast and very efficiently, then you may want to consider supplementing with it. Now, there's two ways you can do this. You can actually get an injection of B12 and you can actually just take it orally. Now, the question becomes, which do I do? Now, what research shows us is getting injections of B12 isn't any more effective than actually taking taking it orally. Now, one of the things that we also know about this is taking it orally is much more cost effective, and it's much easier because you're not having to go and get pricked by a needle and go through that whole process. The next question becomes is, do I take vitamin B12 in the form of cyanocobalamin or methylcobalamin? Now, cyanocobalamin is a synthetic form. It's lab made. It's not really found in nature. And so cyanocobalamin is not a form that you want to take. When you take your B12, you want to take it in the form of methylcobalamin because it is the bioactive form and it's going to be very usable by the body. I take methylcobalamin every single day, and I actually take it in the form of a methylation formula because it's a more effective way and a more complete way to support DNA and support overall neurological health. I'll go ahead and link what I use in the description below here. But if you are someone who is suffering from any of these symptoms, you can get a blood test and you can actually look at B12 and see if you're deficient in it. And then from there, you can supplement with it and raise those B12 levels in the body using both food and supplementation. Other than that, be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, and then check out my other videos that are going to help you improve your health. I'll see you in the next video.